Bonjour, I'm Teva Camille and I'm a botanist of Marien University in Brazzaville. I've been working with the Royal Botanic Gardens of Kew, the Inga Foundation and MPD Congo on a project that I would like to tell you about today. This 10-minute presentation is about how we use herbarium specimens to inform selection of tree species to be used in ongoing experimental tree trial in my country, the Republic of Congo. This experiment uses indigenous African forest species with potential to address our needs for reforestation, carbon capture, agroforestry, and protection of forest with high conservation value. Here on the left, we can see a plot of secondary grassland with bracken fern being prepared and planted in late 2030 in the Zanaga area, Massif du Chaillu. On the right is the same area taken 6 years later, now with indigenous forest trees established, taken in February 2020. In this talk, I will tell you why and how we did this and the important part herbarium specimens played in the choice of species. Co-authors are Mikeans of the Inga Foundation, Martin Tick of RBG, Pierre Mary and Florent Lager of MPD Congo, who host and manage the trial. Idriff Ponzo, a PhD student of Marien University, and Yvette Harvey, the RHS of UK. Large areas of the Massif du Chaillu forest are secondary grassland, fire maintained and dominated by pteridium, a fern resulting from repeated slash and burn agriculture of forest for manioc cultivation. This grassland tracts have low species diversity and are not used by people because the pteridium and grasses make agriculture difficult. Instead, slash and burn continues in areas of intact biodiversity forest where bracken and grasses do not present a problem. To test the hypothesis that we could re-establish indigenous forest trees in this degraded habitat, we established a nursery, you can see at the left, and collected seeds, you can see at the right. We focused on three species with agroforestry potential to parallel Inga species used for this purpose in the Americas. 1. Nitrogen fixing legume with 2. Regrow capacity and 3. With leaflets that were both large and thickly coriaceous so that they would form a durable mulch after pollarding. From a comprehensive species checklist of the Zanaga area based on thousands of collections made by our project, we pulled out all the species of legumes in the group Papilionoidae and Mimosoidae. These groups are known for fixing atmospheric nitrogen by root nodules colonized by bacteria. We then screened herbarium specimens for this species for the trait needed for the project. Large leaflet size combined with high thickness. Finally, we selected from this long list of species those which we found from visit slash and burn farms could regrow after being cut down. The short list contained 12 species. These 12 species became the target of our seed collection effort, used for sowing in the nursery. Germinated seedlings were planted out in pots until 15 to 30 centimeters tall, when they were planted out in holes into the experimental trial. Here is the nursery in fall production in 2012. Our trainee botanist, including myself from Marien, Ngouabi University, helped to set up the plot. Bottom left is Coulter Markens, director of the Inga Foundation, vastly experienced with Inga system in the Americas, and a soil scientist. Here are the seedlings being planted and measured. The planting lines are 3.5 meters apart. Seedlings are planted 0.5 meters apart within the lines. 6 years later, most of our species had formed a canopy, shading out the grasses and pteridium originally present. To our surprise, many forest herb and shrub species appeared, tough to have regenerating from the soil seed bank. This photo shows a parcel of Milicia versicolor, which is valued in Congo as a hardwood. This parcel of Milicia has been pollarded to test its agroforestry potential. The poles will be collected for firewood, and the brush will remain as a mulch for planting crops. The trees will be allowed to regrow when needed. In the Americas, a 1 hectare plot of Inga can grow crops to feed a family permanently without need for slash and burn, reducing production of climate change gases and reducing degradation of and loss of biodiversity conservation priority forest. Here we are measuring tree diameters and taking wood samples to calculate carbon capture over time. Reforesting tracts of secondary degraded grassland offers potential for large-scale carbon sequestration to help address climate change. This photo shows the team in 2020 with Pierre Berry, trial manager, with the first wood samples, and Yvette Ponzo, also co-author in his height. Our project in Congo has been interrupted by COVID in the last year, but now, as normal returns, we will resume. A big thank you to you, NatSCA, for enabling me to share with you the important way in which herbarium specimens have helped us to find suitable indigenous tree species to repopulate areas that have been subjected to repeated slash and burn agriculture, and especially to you for listening to me. Thank you.